Hey, welcome back, guys, and you're still on to Emotional Healing on Freshwaves Radio with Moyo. And today, like I said earlier, before, in case you're just joining in, welcome to Freshwaves Radio. And today we're talking about how to teach your children about their identity. How do you teach your children about their identity? Because we have a lot of grown up out there who are still battling identity crisis, even at the age of 30, at the age of 40, even at the age of 20, even at the age of 50. Some people are still battling identity crisis. So how can we stop this this thread that has gone or has been on for a couple of years? How can we talk about all of these, even right from our children? I think one of the ways that you can teach your children about their identity is for you to challenge your children. If you feel your children are too young to do some certain things, and you feel, oh, you are too young, you can't do this one is not for children, and just sit down, don't do this. When you challenge your children, you're actually tasking them and letting them know that they can do things, they can achieve things. And one thing about challenge is that challenge brings out the best in everybody. Like, is there anyone who has gone through challenges? Like, I'm not talking about, even if it's spiritual self, I don't think there's anyone who has gone through challenges at one point or the other, and that challenge has actually killed them. Maybe you're giving a challenge at your place of work, or you're giving a challenge in school or whatever, you're giving an assignment and all of that. And then that challenge just kills somebody. I don't think I've heard of it. So when you challenge your children, you're actually embracing them up to know that whatsoever task or whatsoever thing they come in contact with in life, they're definitely going to overcome it. And that is part of you building a strong emotion within them, so that they don't get weighed down by their emotions by saying, no, because this thing is tasky, I can't do it and all of that. So you need to know that by challenging your children, you are definitely teaching them to get prepared. You are giving them a sense of who they are. You are painting a picture of who they are to them. And also, you need to know, let your children learn, and as they are learning, you reward their learning. When you're teaching children something, you need to know that, you need to let your children know that they can achieve whatsoever they put in effort into. Now, we have a lot of children that have grown up over time, and their parents will say, oh, my child is exceptionally brilliant, my child is intelligent, my child is this and my child is that. And because they feel that, oh, my child is intelligent, they feel that they don't need to put in work in telling their children that, oh, go and pick up your book and read. And they begin to face those children that they know, okay, they are an average student, or I don't want to use the word dullard, but you understand what I mean. Those children who are the lower, who have low IQ and all of that, not that they don't know what they are doing, but then they don't assimilate as much as an average student or an intelligent student and all of that. And you begin to see parents say that, oh, this child of mine is very intelligent, I don't need to stress her, she knows her book, once they teach her like this, it has entered her brain, straight up. And then they begin to put effort on those children who are average students. I've seen people who have moved from being very intelligent to not knowing anything at all. Not because they did not want to know it, but because their parents felt, oh, these children are intelligent, oh, so they don't need to read, they don't need to stress them. You know, there is, for some of us who grew up with educated parents, we know what our eyes saw in terms of book. Like, your parents go and carry your book. Even before you watch television, say, you must have done some certain things that will wake you into the world of watching that television, so certain extent, or probably when you are in holidays. But that book you will read at midnight. My father will come and wake me up, stand up, read. I remember when I was praying for my junior, dip my leg inside a bowl of water. Let's just leave that part. So you can tell that, or you should know that, because your child is intelligent, doesn't mean that you should not put in efforts for them to read or for them to study. So you need to let your children know that whatsoever they put in work to, they will get the reward of it. Don't let your children know that, oh, because they are just intelligent, and so definitely they should know everything about life, or they should know everything about the academics and all of that. You need to let them know that they need to put in work to achieve some particular things. And also, if you notice that your child has interest in some particular thing, let's say for instance your child has interest in sports and all of that, you can buy games or educational materials around sports, probably I don't know. I think there should be some educational arts. A lot of people are actually doing well in terms of educational apps. There are so many educational apps out there that you begin to wonder how many do you download for your child. When you download some educational apps for your children, some have to do with sports, some have to do with different arts, some have to do with dance and other stuff. Whatever your child decides to pick interest in, you can choose to help them take their interest to a new level by actually buying toys for them around that particular thing that they like and other stuff. So you need to take your child's interest to a new level. Even if it is the academics, check the academics, what subjects they like more. Oh, they prefer more science subjects to art subjects. Then you can go ahead and actually, okay, because they love English more, get them games that has to do with learning new words and all of that. Oh, they love science, get them applications, educational applications that has to do with learning science and all of that. By doing that for them, you're actually bracing them up. You're actually bracing them up and giving them the sense of belonging that they need to become more better, even though they have interest in. You are actually letting them know that, oh, because I have interest in this, my mom is actually encouraging me, or my dad is actually encouraging me to do more of this. And by doing that, you're actually creating an image within them. You're letting them know that, oh, because I have interest in science, so probably they can always find their identity in science, that okay, maybe I'm a scientist, I am this, I am that, and all of that. But you see some certain children, they are the one that they will do science, they are the one that they will do arts, they are the one that will do accounting, they are the one that will do this. And there is not that they can't achieve all of these at the same time, but then because they have not been enlightened, or because they have not been encouraged, their interest, their parents have not encouraged them enough in terms of their interest on how to become better and all of that, they begin to drop interest in, okay, maybe probably because this art I am into, my mom is not showing, she's not showing interest in this art. Maybe if I switch to science, she will like science. Or maybe if I switch to accounting, she will like accounting and all of that. You need to, if you're doing that to your children, you're actually creating conflicts in their identity, because they are not sure of themselves. But if you let your child know that this particular thing you have shown interest in is what you like, is what you want to do, and I am in with you on this, then you're actually arousing. They'll keep doing it. They'll keep doing more. I remember when I was growing up and I just loved reading. When my father saw that, not because he didn't have the money to buy more books for me, but then there are other things to use money to do and all of that, he started collecting newspapers. My daddy would collect newspapers from his friends, and I read newspapers. As in, even though I was not that interested in the news aspect and all of that, I've never been like reading news up until I grew up. I never had interest in news, okay? So I wasn't really interested in the news. But see, you see those editorials, those articles at the back of newspaper, you find me there. And I'm someone that also loves animation so much. With all those cartoons at the back of that newspaper, I would read them, and I was always following them because my daddy kept bringing home more newspapers. So I was always looking out for the following week and all of that. He kept bringing it, and with that, I knew that, oh, my dad really wanted me to do this. When I got to GS3 and I wanted to switch, because in Nigeria, when you get to GS3, that's when you switch to, okay, art, science, or commercial department and all of that. I said I wanted to be in art department, and my mom was like, no, you are brilliant, oh, you cannot do art, oh, it's science you do, I want you to become. I said, no, I want to be in art department. And my dad was like, oh, because I know that this child has always had interest in books, in reading, in newspaper and all of that stuff. And it was just like, madam, let's just leave this girl, let her do what she wants to do. And to God be the glory, they are not regretting it today, okay? Because I had always seen that in myself, that, oh, more, this girl go talk. She will talk, like she's a talker, all right? So, and apart from other stuff that they had seen. So you also, as a parent, you need to be intentional about the things your child show interest into. Don't just say because, oh, maybe this girl is just reading because she see her friend reading. No. Take note of every single details of your child. And once you notice that your child is picking interest in a particular thing, get them materials that would support that thing they are showing interest into, so that you'll be aware and you will know where to come in at each particular time. You also need to teach your children to be assertive. You need to teach your children to be positive, regardless of whatever situation they are going through. You need to teach them to be positive, because if they have issues with their self-esteem, it will affect their identity. If they have low self-esteem, it will affect their identity. It will affect who they will be. So you really need to put work on making sure that you avoid low self-esteem in your children. Encourage them. Let them know that they are enough. Let them know that they are enough. Like, they are enough for themselves. Even though they might have mates who are doing more than them and all of that, it should not be the end of the world for them. And it should not make them feel that, oh, probably because I'm not as good as this girl in school, so I'm not enough. Let your children know that they are enough. And that is why, as parents, you need to be very, very careful in creating differences or, I'm trying to find the right word now, in comparing your children. Yes, that's the right word. So parents will be like, look at you, you're not even reading your book. Hey, da 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 da. And look at that girl. That girl, once she get home like this, she will carry her book and read. But you will not read. You will just be playing around. I don't know if it's well. And especially African parents. African parents. God have mercy on us. So I want to believe that the trend, the rise of parents we are having in this era is becoming different from the kind of parents that raised we. Even though our parents were a bit intentional about us, but this set of parents that are coming up, we need to be more intentional about our children by letting them know that our self-esteem is something. Don't compare it to your children. Don't compare your first child to your last child. Don't compare your children with another set of children, because by doing that, you're affecting your child's low self-esteem, either directly or indirectly. Whether you want to believe it or not, you're affecting their self-esteem. So you need to know that your child is unique in their own way. You need to let your children know that they are unique in their own way, and no other person can be like them. And they also don't need to be like any other person. They just need to be themselves. Like, they just really need to be themselves. All right, so put that into consideration, and it will help your children in identifying their identity. We'll go on a short music break, and when I'm back, we continue this discussion on children identity. I'll be right back. Welcome back, guys, and you're still on to Emotional Healing on Freshwaves Radio with Moyo. And we're talking about how to teach your children about their identity at a very early stage in life. Another tip I'm going to be giving to you on how to teach your children about their identity, or how to help your children in realizing their identity, is for you not to protect your children too much. If you are an overprotective parent, you're definitely going to have problem. Like, that child, you're definitely giving that child problem, in case you don't know. If you don't allow it, just imagine, I think I think I can't remember where I saw it, but I saw something on Instagram. I don't know if it was Mrs. Toju Oyo that posted it, or Dr. Mrs. Emanuela Mike-Bamiloye. I'm not too sure which of them posted it, because of course I'm a reader and I'm a follower. Okay, so one of them posted it that at a particular stage of their life, they watched their it was Mrs. Toju Oyo. She said she watched her son, like, gradually, he was always trying to climb the staircase, and she was always afraid that, oh, this child, I hope this child will not fall. And before she knew it, this child had, because she was always, she said at the initial stage, she kept following the child closely anytime the child was climbing the staircase. And then gradually, before she knew it, she just, that child started climbing the staircase, and she wasn't paying attention, but then she knew that that child has grown to an extent that that child cannot fall from the staircase, because that child has gained strength. That child has known that, oh, that child already has the boldness that I can do this thing without falling and all of that. So the same thing also applies regardless of the age of your children. If you are overprotective and you're like, no, I don't want my child to climb this, you know, I don't want my child to do this, I don't want to let my child go out, I don't want to allow my child mix with these people and all of that, you're definitely doing more harm than good to your children. I'm not saying in terms of moral upbringing you should not be strict, not that you are strict, but then you should not be firm in protecting your children and all of that. Of course, if you do not protect your children, who will protect your children for you except God, shall? But then you really need to, okay? So you need to know that don't protect your children too much, because if you protect them too much, you're doing more harm than good to them. So it is natural for us to want to protect them, but we should try as much as possible not to go overboard, because when you protect your children too much, you will not allow them to use failure to learn success. And for most of us that we are at this, as in, at least for we youth, I don't know what category to put us, but at least we are no longer teenagers and all of that, we know that most of the things we learned, or most of the successes we have today, they are from what we learned. Like, they are lessons that we learned from our failure. Even though some of us might not be a direct experience, but we learned from other people's experience. We learned from some people's failure, and we decide not to follow that same path because when they tried it, they failed. So we decided that we have watched those people, and we don't also want to make that same mistake. So for some of us, we learned from ourselves. Like, we made mistakes, we corrected ourselves, and we begin to have success in all of those things. So you also, when you are less protective of your children, you're actually teaching them to actually learn or achieve success from their failure. But if you are protecting them, that once they fall, you pick them up. Whenever that child falls again, that child will not learn how to pick himself or herself up. That's where I'll be rounding up on the program today. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you've learned a thing or two on emotional healing on Freshwaves Radio with Moyo. And I do hope you join me same time, same station next week, by God's grace. And I hope next week you will not come alone. Like, I do hope you will not come alone. You definitely come with as many people as possible. Don't forget if you are listening from a friend's device, or probably you're watching this later on in the future, for those that are watching, just know it that you just have to go to your Google Play Store or your iOS Store to download the Freshwaves Radio app. If you cannot download the Freshwaves Radio app, or probably the device you're using does not support the Freshwaves Radio app, you can simply listen on the go, either by typing it on your browser or your Chrome browser by typing www.freshwavesradio.com. And you can also reach out to us on any of our social handles, on Facebook at Freshwaves Radio, on Instagram at Freshwaves Radio Online. And we're definitely going to revert back as soon as possible. Thank you so much for joining me today. I pray God bless you, your home, your marriages, your relationship. Most importantly, I pray God bless you. Remain in God, and God bless you. Till I come your airwaves again next week, by God's grace. Remain in God.
Sometimes life can weigh upon your shoulders.
Thank you so much.